Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers, welcome back to my sofa. Today's video, you'll see by the introduction, it's a bit too dramatic, okay? I wanted to have a bit of fun, so last week I asked you on Instagram to challenge me with some fragrance battle. So you've done it very well, and I said to you that I was open-minded to different questions as well. So you asked quite like a funny thing as well. Hope you're gonna enjoy. I thought it was going to be a bit more funny. I'll try to explain my choice, but not too much, otherwise this video is gonna last ages. And hopefully it's gonna be battles that I can do in the future. If you really interested in one battle, please write down in the comments and I will try to do a video on it. Before we start the video, let me just explain to you two things. The first thing is this is not an Illuminati symbol, this is the Deathly Hallows by Harry Potter. And the second thing is this is gonna be ultra subjective. So to explain that, I'm gonna quote Dumbledore. It is our choices that show what we truly are, not our abilities. Harry. Let's go directly to the subject and start. So I've got the screenshot here. So I didn't watch the screenshot before. I really screenshot very quickly and I let at least like a 1 week and a half or something go through those things. So I completely forgot what you said and I hope you're not gonna trick me, but as I remember, there were some tricky ones. But yeah, let's start directly to the subject. Okay, Nils Hampus, Prada L'Homme Editi or Dior Homme? Original formulation on both, of course. Ooh, I like the little precision. Okay, Nils, that's for me quite easy. I will go Dior Homme because I think the original formulation already have that touch of iris. That was really a good revolution to perfumery as it was slightly going more to the flowery side. And I really enjoy that powdery deepness in Dior Homme. I think Prada L'Homme Editi is a nice office scent, quite casual, versatile, but it's an easy to wear. I think Dior Homme's got a bit more depth, so I will go Dior Homme. Donna 24 ici, salut, j'adore ton profil, n'hésite pas à venir sur mon compte. Oui. Vachel 93, a perfume that matches your personality. I would say the one that I feel the most connected with is probably number 22 as my signature scent because it's vintage, it's opulent, it's confident, and that's it. I really hesitated with Penelope's Revenge of Lady Blanche for that mysterious vibe. I think yeah, it's a bit too dangerous anyway. Next one. Stam 330, coffee or tea? Coffee, but I'm trying to reduce my coffee consumption because it's stressing me out. But I do love a jasmine tea or a black sherry tea. Felipe, Marion Cotillard or Gisèle Bündchen for the face of Chanel No. 5? Personally, I'll prefer Gisèle Bündchen. I really enjoy the campaign that was done at the moment. I think it was so beautiful. She's really Chanel, as she's really elegant and natural and spontaneous. And that's really something I think that is showing a lot of elegance when you don't need to show too much to be elegant. It's really inside of you, it's not outside the elegance. So I think for me Gisèle is doing the best job out of that. Marion Cotillard, I always a bit struggle with our actress vibes, so but she's doing really well. The face again, she's beautiful, so you know. Felipe, crème brûlée au tiramisu? Very difficult. You're trying to trick me, Felipe. Crème brûlée. Because after all the bœuf bourguignon I'm eating, I like something very, very light, like the crème brûlée. Flores, Michael Lang, Grey Vetiver or Acqua di Gio Profumo for the office? Which is the best designer office? Grey Vetiver for me, I prefer it because I love a vetiver touch. I think it's earthy, elegant, refined, and there's a touch of that vintage style with vetiver that I really enjoy. Yes, so for me that will be this one. Xavier Capus, MFK Acqua Vitae versus Nasomato, pardon. That's really difficult because the two of them are very different. I'll go to Vitae because I like how MFK, Maison Francisca Dijon, do their fragrance, very simple, but very like a deepness slightly there. I like the refinement of the fragrance, even though Nasomato, pardon, is extremely beautiful. I will go MLFK. Farra, FRRA.PL. Hi, Clément, CC Fragrance. Xavier Capus, it's again you. Hey! Girls of Olfacti Studio, Still Life in Rio. Étonnant. I don't know this. My knowledge is very limited. Scented Snowdrops. Hi, John. I need a hard one. I got a British perfume or French perfume house. Is that even difficult? Don't hate me after that, okay? Don't hate me after that. So I've done a video on in French, actually, like a short time ago about British house that I really love. Houses like Floris, for example, or Penelligans that I think for me are absolutely stunning. And I really enjoy the very different character, much more, I would say, kind of creative vibe of the British culture. I don't know, I really like it. But I'm French, so I can't deny my own country, you know what I mean? And I mean, I was raised into the French perfumery, and for me, I can't, you know, Chanel, Dior, Hermès, Lanvin, anything like that, Guerlain. It's just there's too many that I absolutely love, and for me, they are a massive part of our history in France, so definitely French house. But you kind of expected it. Cheers, Mkin1063. I use storyvoter.com. Grow safely, faster than ever. Sphinx.Robert. I hope I don't say your name bad. Prada L'Homme on Prada Im. And Prada Amber pour l'Homme. Again, I would choose Prada Amber pour Homme because this is really my family of fragrance, a bit more ambery, oriental. I think it gives sensuality to a man. So I would go Prada Amber. Dinindale 2993. Do you like fashion? Yes, I love it. Only if it's vintage. Anthony Jimenez. L'Odyssée versus Guerlain Vetiver. Definitely Guerlain Vetiver. I mean, I've got it. I love it. This Vetiver, very like punchy at the beginning and a kind of nice warm down that, like, for me, will still be there years and years after. It's still modern, even though it's a very like dated fragrance. And yeah, no, 100%. Guerlain Vetiver. Platinum, Chanel Platinum Egoist or Bleu de Chanel. Definitely, I will go Bleu de Chanel, especially the Eau de Parfum that I love with this slightly amber tone that perfectly balances this grapefruit note. It's beautiful. Platinum Egoist, I really like it as well, but it's a fougère scent and. Fougère is not the family that I enjoy the most personally, but it's beautiful. Tony Jimenez, Dior Homme or Dior Homme Intense? Dior Homme Intense, 100%. Yes. So much more darkness is beautiful. Tom Ford Tuscan Leather versus Fucking Fabulous. Choose. This is too difficult. I mean, Tuscan Leather is so beautiful. It's an amazing leathery scent. Lots of character. That touch of raspberry is beautiful. But I love the churchy, mysterious vibe of Fucking Fabulous. I think it's so sexy. It's gonna be Fucking Fabulous. Sorry, Felipe. Ah, you again. Beatles or Rolling Stone? 100% Beatles. Beatles. Capat 1206. Acqua di Gio Profumo o Profondo? Profumo. Funky Fragrance Lovers. Dior Homme Original or Chanel Allure Homme? Oh no. Honestly, like this is. I hate you. Joking. That's too difficult. I think I can have a joker, right? I can. Yes. Giordano.gomez, Ambre Nuit or Bois d'Argent Foemen. Ambre Nuit, I love ambre nuit. I think it's a very essential fragrance for men, and I prefer that vibe. Bois d'argent is beautiful, but I think it's more that office suit kind of vibe, very trendy, a bit more trendy for me. Honestly, that's what I think. I prefer the warmness and the mysterious sensual vibe of definitely the ambre nuit. Lydia Beerly, hello, I'm thrilled you followed me. Did I? You're welcome. Cyril Parek, Terre d'Hermès. Arrêtez de me parler Terre d'Hermès au bleu de Chanel. I should have used this joke for that. Honestly, it's two different choices. Like, bleu de Chanel is like kind of like a more trendy elegance, a lot of richness that for me will be there years and years after. It's definitely a classic coming, 100%, if it's not already. And Terre d'Hermès is already a classic, and it's more like casual chic elegance, du effortless elegance, completely different for me, with this orange and pepper bitten. I can't Terre d'Hermès. Okay, next one. Funky fragrance lovers. No, that's the same question. Okay, sorry dear, still not answering. Chung Scents, Guerlain, L'Homme Idéal, Cologne or Bulgari Wood Essence. I would choose Bulgari Wood Essence because I've tried it more and I think it was a really nice flanker. So for me, I will go Wood Essence, even though the L'Homme Idéal is quite different anyway. It's more summery. But I'm gonna do a video of L'Homme Idéal, so flankers to compare them. So it's gonna be coming. Kay Can 42 Baccarat 540 Baccarat Rouge Oud for Greatness. I mean, Oud for Greatness, 100%. I mean, I love the fact that Baccarat Rouge made a little revolution into the perfumery with this really caramelized saffron vibe that inspired a lot of fragrance after, but for me, that's Oud for Greatness. I find this fragrance soothing, sexy, and perfectly balanced and not too animalier. It's stunning. So, Oud for Greatness. Jaga Yones, office for men or date for men, but you already had it. Had this already. Definitely office for men. I mean, date for men is really nicely done, but for me, no. Office for men is great. I quite enjoy wearing it, actually. It's nice. Date for men is a bit more too much. It's too trendy, it's too punchy, it's too, for me. Seju Stone Q, Mir and Tonka versus Grand Soir. You, I know you've done that on purpose because you probably know that this is probably gonna be two of my favorite scents. Impossible. Why have I done that to myself? Oud for Greatness. What? See? How I'm like, I can't think. Grand Soir, I mean, because it was one of the best discovery of last year, with Oud for Greatness probably, and I like this amber that is very bright, a bright amber. I think it's quite rare, so I will go for Oud for Greatness. What? Grand Soir. Even though I love Mir and Tonka, I love it. That's not fair. You're not nice. Malenica, Portrait of a Lady or for Narciso Rodriguez. I don't really usually like rosy fragrance, but I have to say Portrait of a Lady is one of my favorite rosy scents. I absolutely love it. It's beautiful. For Narciso Rodriguez, I mean, I love it as well, but it's got a more strong, deep connection to myself. I mean, if you look at the name, I would definitely go for Portrait of a Lady because it's a bit more me. But I would get for Narciso Rodriguez because when I start working perfumery, it was one of the first. Murillo's Israel, Givenchy Zerius Rouge or Cartier Déclaration d'un Soir. Cartier Déclaration d'un Soir, definitely. It's a very, the two are very good classic, but I prefer the versatility and the light elegance of Cartier. I do have personally a lot of Cartier, so I love them. Glory Grace, Jonathan Garner 95 Chanel Allure Homme Sport Édition Blanche versus Parfum de Marly Leighton Definitely Allure Homme Sport Édition Blanche. I really enjoy Parfum de Marly for sure, but I think the Édition Blanche got more like a dandy style with this very sharp lemony tone and the sandalwood that is very creamy. I find it personally really elegant for a nice warm daytime or a daytime in winter as well. So I, for me, it's more refined. Thank you everyone for joining through this little game together. Tell me in the comment again which is the most battles that you want to see me answer and probably do a video on it. And tell me what was the most challenging for you, if you didn't agree, whatever, tell me everything. Thank you again for being always so reactive on Instagram, it's lovely. And for the one who are not following me on Instagram, I really encourage you to do so because we have fun. Remember to always subscribe to my YouTube channel because I know like there's a lot of people not subscribing while watching the video. It gives me a little help and it's very free. So anyway, thank you again and I wish you a lovely day. Take life positive and take all the little things that you can get. That's it. Bye now.